come to the Good Morning Nigeria show. Frankly, Frank, he talk finish at State Consign Business for Obodo, Nigeria. And I dey very sure, say, people don't learn. I won't beg una. See, the Good Morning Nigeria show don't turn to university. He don't polytech, anyone, just call up. So every day, once he knock seven, carry your biro, carry your book, begin the write. Especially when they reach where we carry our ogbonge visitors come. And where Franklin, they talk about business. Make we discuss with our ogbonge visitor, this young man, a person will be saying, he sabi well. If we go all the university when they inside of Obodo, Nigeria, contact them, say, maybe they mention people when we say, they feel beat their chest, say, yes, this one, our product, we dey proud of him. He get one university for this country where we say, anytime when they mention the name, they go just smile. They go smile because the things when they do, nothing when we say, if you not get sense, you don't be thinking, wait, man, just leave him. He gets some things where we say, now only people when get sense, they do him. And this is our own visitor, the person where we say, in get sense, where. Him the person when come in, look, say, our tertiary institutions, that is, our universities, them, all these senior places, people, they go, they learn book. It's not supposed to be place where we say, people go, they smoke it, go, they join courts, they do runs, they do bad boys, they do bad girls, no bet gang, no bra gang. He said that place where we say, people, when we say, their head, they command fire, suppose they. And he get one idea where we say, by the time when he talk and finish, when I go trip, and they talk to my brother, where we be almost Saleko Gongo. He come from Lagos, and he get passion for this country. Elder David, welcome to Good Morning Nigeria show, my brother. Technology, after I knock this better introduction, technology won't come to do anyhow. But I dey very sure, say, the thing go balance, and Elder David go follow us for this particular discussion. We're going to just give him a small profile, so that we're going to say, this person that they talk about, now senior person inside of Obodo, Nigeria, when it comes to making young people, they use their idea. Elder David, now forerunner, now person will be saying, he dey for front, when he reach to say, for our universities then, we need make our young people them, they think. Make you not be saying a bad thing. Now you're going to think, I want to think how to do Yahoo. I want to think how to do runs boy. I want to think how to join court. I want to think how to smoke bowl. I want to think how to jump fence. I want to think how to be pursuing girls small up and down. No. Now how to think when they go use their brain, take change this country. Take make the fool world they look say, hey, Nigerians, they think like this. We cut cap, give them. Now what do they mean when they say somebody in a forerunner for the kind of profession or the kind of work when we say Elder David, they do. And then they call this one the Academia Industry Alliance. People wear sabi book, industry, that is all this is what they do. Say, okay, oh, we they build things, we they manufacture things, we they construct things, we they do things in the area. Elder David, welcome to Good Morning Nigeria show.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Morning.
Make we no waste time, make we just go straight into our discussion. Some people go look your face, they will say, Elder David, Elder. See the name when in the answer, Elder. Shena Elder, but I don't spell him, say your own Elder, na E-L-D-A. Now your name be that, not be whether you don't hold. But we go look, say, wait, oh. All these people go come, they tell us, say, we love Nigeria. Let's do things about Nigeria. They really love Nigeria. I mean, in English, now in food, they out. Now they come, they talk to us. This one went fresh like this. He wear glass, when get color red. They tell us, say, we love Nigeria. Elder David, I won't ask you. I won't make you look our people there when they watch you for eye and tell them how passionate you day about our country. Nigeria. Tell them the things when they ginger you, when they make your heart, they burn for this our country, Nigeria. And they hear you, Elder David.
Okay, so first things first, my name is Elder. Elder, E-L-D-A. The meaning of Elder is the child of necessity. So anytime you see call my name, so they call that Elder, it gets to resonate with my purpose. So, and of course, as a Nigerian, as a young Nigerian for that matter, you know, I'm very passionate about Nigeria and of course the potential that Nigeria has. For many people, you know, see, many people don't talk to Nigeria don't spoil, Nigeria don't start up, Nigeria, you know, plenty things where we say, if you go other countries, why don't travel go? You see the way young people get opportunity, the way mature people get old people get opportunity. Even people who don't retire, as they don't retire, they get benefits, social benefits, when the city government they give them. But in Nigeria, many of these things, no day. And the thing I say, for young people like us, we see, we don't be fortunate to travel, go to different places. We don't see, the people who do all these things for abroad, they don't get 2 heads, they don't get 5 heads. Every one of them, could they go, and a better thinking, and anything they do, anything they do. So for me, my passion for Nigeria, and I say, if we will change this country, now policy, public policy, Now we will use change in Nigeria. Mm. We will not be use ginger or gaga or fight to change this country. Mm. If at all we want to change this country, as young people, we must be involved in policy making. So for me, the way that they do my own, I say, rather make they carry placard for road, they fight, they cause war, they cause Jonathan, mm. cause PDP, cause APC. Why are not just they involved? Begin, they see how happy as my own voice for policy making. Mm. So my baba will be politician, my mama will be politician, I will not be any politician. But the good thing I say, because of the value I carry, onto my passion for Nigeria, and because of say, this is to one play politics for future, this is the one they involve in policy making. So at the start in my own small way, mm-hmm. for my job what they do, and for the things what they do today. Mm-hmm. So my passion for Nigeria is very, very, very strong. Mm-hmm. I don't get the opportunity to even take relocate, if people want to sponsor my application. But I tell them, say no, and Nigeria me want to. I like Nigeria very well.
Hmm. Elder David, some people go look you finish, they go talk, say, wait, oh. We know, say, your own elder na E-A-E-L-D-A, but we go change them for you to E-L-D-E-R. If you ask them why, they go talk, say, when they look your face, then they see calendar. They say, when they hear you speak, you they think like person will be say, as you did like this, you don't already there 2035. You know, they think like person went there 2020 already. He get one idea where you get. You talk, say, as you look yourself, oh, you look young people inside of Bodo Nigeria, and you look everything where concern human capital, say, then go invest in young people, and young people in turn go contribute to make Nigeria better. You talk something about, say, he get one ministry based on, say, youth, young people inside of Bodo Nigeria. You say, we get one particular ministry when they now, but based on futuristic thinking, looking at the future and the way where Nigeria are they get the way where you go like make them rebrand that thing and you go to work for Nigeria. I go like make you just share that idea so that people go understand. Say, even though we're in 2020, sometimes our thinking need to be forward thinking. Make I hear you.
Are you true? So for me, as a person, as an individual, I'm very passionate about human capital development. And I tell people, see, for any country to develop in young people in future, human capital development, I think that's the focus of waiting that country to focus on. So the good thing I say, yes, as BK talk, I'm like 2 years ago, say Nigeria needs to develop a human capital development framework. Our federal government don't want to respond, don't develop, of course, something we say they want to do. But for me, my own thinking, my own big thing, I say, me want to become minister of youth. But now, not be the minister of youth this today, when we say youth and sport and only political things that they do. My own kind of thinking, I say, the future ministry of youth to focus strictly on human capital development, health issues, education issues, and future of jobs still for young people. So even if I don't want to go to university, but I want to learn software engineering, I want to learn software development, or I want to learn nothing, or I want to learn theory, or I want to learn anything, I should skill learn them. And this ministry of young people and human capital development, now in should post. They get responsibility for pushing this human capital development framework on Nigeria as it be. Now, as it be today now, Nigeria don't get any specific plan, any specific framework for young people in terms of human capital development. So who not get money to even go to university? To a large extent, they'll end up at university because of the human capital development framework, no day. But if you don't get human capital development framework, that ministry will stay in tune with what young people will fit to in the next 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. So for me, my long-term plan is to everything what they do today in policy making, now to build myself to become, of course, that minister of youth. Hmm. I think my the minister of youth for you and I say, me, I want to attain this ambition for my club 40 years old. So from now to that, to fear achieve them.
Elder David, you don't set target for yourself. Oh. You said before you clock 40, you won't attend that particular ambition. Our young people in the house, now they watch, he saying get 12 years. He know what he didn't want. He don't set plan for himself. You go wake up every morning, they talk, say, The only futuristic thing where you see now, say, Chelsea go win Premier League. Liverpool go beat Arsenal. 2-1. 2, correct score. Begin to think of where when we say you can take move your future and control your own destiny. But David, make I ask you, you talk something about human capital development, and you talk about investing in human capital. Plenty Nigerians, them, I go like make you break down this human capital development and the investment, make we understand. Because some Nigerians, anytime when they hear investment, Their owner say, give me money. Now why politicians go come? Carry 500 and share for us before election. We will collect on election day. Instead of vote for people where we say they get ideas, we'll go vote for people where we say they share money, give us. After 4 years, we'll begin to cry. We'll continue to complain. Maybe we talk about this human capital. Maybe we look at young population inside of Nigeria and talk the importance of investing in young people for this country. And what in exactly this investment be? Say that they go give us palm oil, share yam, and all of us go begin to chop, or they'll give us 500. What is exactly with this investment, Elder David?
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. In fact, this matter of human capital development, I did very, very, very passionate about them. And the good thing I see, myself and some other young Nigerians are through the Nigerian Global Affairs Council. Now, one policy thing can be say, not the political think tank, not the support any political party. Our job now to think, research excellent ideas, excellent research programs, so we say, come and feed you. So at the moment, this think tank, myself and these people, these young people, so all of us, we follow the team within Nigeria to do under a human capital development framework. So the three major areas of this human capital development framework now, health, education, and skills, future of job. Now, under this labor, so I want to focus on this labor, this skill itself, because the thing I say, some people don't want to go to university. Some people don't even get money to go to university. Some people, even if they go to university, they graduate, they don't go to TikTok. So, what is the government to do to develop these young people at their capacity? Now, number one, I think federal government introduce a national apprenticeship program. My brother, so of they see how people boys, they bring their brother from Enugu, Anambra, they will carry them go like before, carry them go Alaba, carry them go other places, they will say they will start to solve business, or they will start paper business. But before they start, they will try to serve one of that. Like 2 or 3 years. Now the problem is that all of the people they bring from, they don't know anything about processing, about structure. So many times, or their business, or they see business will not die like that. So my own thing is that federal government, in order to create wealth, to create entrepreneurs, to create jobs, fits do a national apprenticeship program. So if you go to this school, finish. Now, federal government, people say, okay, we don't want to be university. You think about this apprenticeship program for like 2 or 3 years, so go learn under one worker. Even if you go to university or you don't see a job or you want to learn business, you'll go learn on the form already. But the good thing I say, because of saying you pass through this national apprenticeship program, they go give special training about processing, about structure. So that when you start your business too, all those things will be said, all those people know to be educated. You said go fit to work. If you want to learn something, you want to learn machine learning. You want to learn artificial intelligence. Any basic skill you want to learn, we will not see how things compete in people. Make sure that government has a national apprenticeship program. Now, beyond that one, you get people who say, if they don't want to work, they don't want to do business, now they work, they want to work. So, part of our team can say, see what things make the government do. When they talk, say, our young people, who they employable, they don't get jobs because of pay, they're not stable, they're not employable. But the truth I say, for Nigeria, we never entrench culture of internship for young people. Now only the way they enter with the education, with the nursing, with the medicine, and then they go to internship. So before they graduate, before they get ready, before they get NYSC, come on, they don't get small experience. So my thinking is that make federal government, human capital development framework, introduce a national internship program, make it compulsory for every undergraduate between their long holiday to go on internship. So, at this internship, make them make sure they account as work experience according to the law where they will make them. So that way, any graduate, any other graduate today have no longer holiday, will not say, I need to go find a job because that's part of the requirement why I need to graduate. And if I find this job, if I even graduate, it will be count as work experience. So imagine undergraduate will go 3 months every long holiday for 4 years. It means that in 4 years, he will not get 3 months experience. If you call Adam to NYSC, he will not get 2 years work experience. Now, with that one, he will not build in capacity. And my thinking is that as government, they do that internship, they must also do workplace readiness program that can be delivered virtually. They must not do physical work. Every undergraduate gets laptop, get smartphone. Universities don't get internet. So, make a national workplace readiness program. So, after they learn for knowledge, practice to do the long day of skill. So you don't get out. I don't know what you're doing. Those people talk to the man, do business, say that, talk to the man. They don't think at all. Now, last thing we're going to est franchi de ma carte de remède pour moi. Ma mère est une plumée. Il est un peu excellent. Mais mon état, c'est excellent pour la solution qui est tôt. Je ne dois pas se détruire. C'est pour Nigeria. On peut dire à la façon dont on a fait un peu de gradué. Tu peux me dire, je me donne des académiques session by now. Je ne dois pas faire un mot à 8 points.
Yes.
Now, what do you have to do? If they don't clock past 26 by next year, what if they don't go NYS, if they don't graduate? So my thinking is that as government incorporates national internship program, as government they incorporate workplace readiness program, government need to also incorporate a law to increase the age limit for graduate education to 30 years old. Because some people, they don't get money when they play secondary school, they won't go school immediately. Some people now ask to pass away, we say they go pass 26 years old. But some people, they don't just forget admission on time. Make I give you statistics. Last year, 2 million people write CHAM. Only 650,000 people gain admission.
Hey.
Now, those 1.2 million people will gain admission. What happened to them? Hmm. And some people not be saying that, no, they don't just get up to get admission on time to the university. So when you add all those precedents, you don't be saying Nigeria don't use scatter their age, scatter their life. I want to help them. Hmm. I will not say unemployment is there. They don't think get a job. But the system already, don't already work against them. So just to recap the 3 points I talk. First thing, whether government fits or incorporates a national apprenticeship program, focus on agriculture, focus on the value chain, focus on spare parts, focus on cloth production. See, for example, may I give you how Nigeria at this time will see the import used second hand clothes. On Nigeria. Why we say we not be produced for ABBA? ABBA is an industrial hub. Why not carry our young graduates? Make they go ABBA, go learn how to do production, how to do manufacturing. All those things will be said will be for Nigeria. But we will carry the dollars. Go they buy them for China. Go they buy them for abroad. Go they buy them for one clothes, for one shoe. When we get plenty young graduates, we say if government incorporate them into this apprenticeship program, some of them only they will learn the skill. Some of them are the marketing side of it. Some of them are the sales that they do. Some of them are the social media branding that they do. But the problem is that government needs to have a coordinated national apprenticeship program to incorporate people who go to school and people who don't go to school so that everybody goes to school to get empowered, to feel make up their life economically.
Hmm. Elder David, you don't finish talk as it takes concern this matter. Even myself, I don't work on and they do because I they digest the thing and the thing they enter and I very sure say plenty Nigerians when they watch this morning, they go look say, eh? So we get young people when get this kind of brilliant idea. And if we put all these things, Nigeria go go the permanent side. But make I ask you this last one before I allow you carry Waka come out for us inside our studio. People they talk say, it ain't easy for us to talk. We get the plan. But to do harm, now the problem. And many people, they complain, say, old people, full government. These old people, when they're government, they don't care about young people, when full Nigeria. They even talk, say, even the young people self, now PA, SSA, DSA, MMA, LLA, PPA, now in them, they find. This one, yes, sir. Now many of them, they talk. Many of them don't stand and take their place as young leaders when we say, go put all these things into action. Make I ask you, Elder David, after these brilliant ideas, she now say those when they there, they're not they hear. They get coconut head, they're not they hear. So if we do the right thing and see, say, this thing, we see the result, or these ideas when we get, now only when it reach to discuss them for TV, now would they discuss them. When it reach to implement them, it's not they workable at all. How we go take for ensure, say, our leaders them, and young people will constitute over 60% of Nigeria population, they go stand and see, say, these brilliant ideas, this is what you don't talk, that is what we go do, and Nigeria go move forward. I be make we fast and pray. Yeah.
So I'll answer two, I'll this your question on that two ways. Answer me too.
Okay.
So the first question now, as per young people, who say they do SA, PA, SSC, TSA, all those placements, SA, what they do. Now, the truth that say, my other, nobody just wake up from kindergarten, go university straight. You must start from kindergarten to nursery, to primary, to secondary, to university, to master's, PhD. Nobody just become professor, just like that. So now the problem with policy making is that nobody just wake up say you want to become minister. Nobody just wake up tomorrow say you want to become a director general or governor or president. If you never get real experience inside policy making, you never get real experience inside governance. So most times, the best way to get this experience now make you start with how you see. So if my essay you see, make it one. If my consultant you see, make it one. If my technical advisor you see, make it one. Because brother, you know, easy for mouth, easy for money, but they have to make points. But when you enter inside, you will see say, many, many dynamics, many, many politics, okay, inside out of the wrong political government program. So for me, nothing wrong for young people to start from the background. Even if you know they before the SA to the SA to the SA today, so long as they contribute through research, many background of they don't already do research, they don't already compile them, they don't even bring and come outside. So please, young people will be always cost, young people where they collect all those positions. You not get out to become minister or director general tomorrow if you never get experience. So and you must not get up for government. You people get up for workplace, for private sector. Go build your own capacity. Go achieve something. Now also the value way they people will bring invite you come inside government. So if not from small position they give you, that's from there. Now that's number one. Now number two, the other politicians they accept better ideas. Now other Abita you say politicians they accept better ideas. Yes. Many politicians, many government officials, they accept better ideas. And make tell you something about me. Oftentimes, the president, the governor, the deputy governor, vice president, they go don't think the good idea. Many times, are the people who take down the civil servants, now them be the problem. Because the president, so he go think he's going to do a thing they don't plan. He only have to think the idea. Okay. But now, still civil servants, people like me and you, ordinary Nigerians, are them go to go implement them. So most times, if you see what thing they spoil, now those civil servants have this problem. So I think that you say, this idea is what we talk now. We know that they sit here, they talk about. We already they connect with the Ministry of Labor, the Ministry of Finance, the Ministry of Youth, then of course, even for the Vice President's office, because now the Vice President, now he has been the chairman of the Human Capital Development Working Group on Nigeria. So we know who will be the author. We already they work to connect with them. And the good thing I say, government officials, they listen. Government officials, they get. So the only way we talk about when implementation comes, say our civil servants will do well, make this plan work. Because worry or they don't go through the work. I feel like civil servants go to the work. So now that we encourage our civil servants, they do what they're supposed to. As civil servants, working for the good of Nigeria.
Elder David, make I ask you this last question. We don't talk about government, we don't talk about civil servants. But make we know come out eye for the young population of Nigeria. In fact, for inside Obodo Africa, if they calculate based on age, after Uganda, Nigeria get plenty young people who get sense for this country, outside this country, and we do well for every area where we find ourselves. But it be like say somehow, the things when they encourage young people to feel do well, the things not too plenty. Now, the ones when they discourage them or they give them idea to do bad thing. If somebody like you, Elder David, will get plans to say, okay, oh, by the time you reach 40 years, we'll be 12 years from now. It gets some steps where you go take now to reach one level. We won't make people like you, they inspire young Nigerians. So I go like make you look Nigerians there for I, Koro Koro, this morning. Clear your throat 3 times. Come speak to the heart of young Nigerians. Encourage them the reason why you be say, as young people, they're not supposed to give up on this country. You talk, say you get opportunity to come up for this country, but you say, no, I ain't gonna go. I'm gonna stay to repair this country. I won't make you look young people for eye. Give them hope this morning and encourage them on the need for them not to give up hope for this country and why they must continue to the work to see say Nigeria move go the permanent site. I didn't hear you, Elder David.
So I don't come on my exam.
You come on your class. The thing they pay you, you come on your class.
So first things first, like what I tell young people like this. Now, Buhari and all those old men politicians who will be saying don't hold this country for the last 50 years. For me, Buhari then will be the last vestige of old man politicians who will hold this country. I know people who hold past Buhari who will come back again. After Buhari, my team will say, now people from maybe 50, early 60, now them will be president of this country. So, brother, it means that in the next 15 years, in the next 20 years, in the next 10 years, in the next 5 years, some of us today, when we say we want to build our capacity, we want to work on ourselves, we feel begin to get opportunity to enter government, either through appointment or through election. Now, many of people talk say, things don't spoil, things don't scatter. But like I tell people, now, see, now, perspective, My papa don't get money, my mama don't get money, I don't get any uncle who get money. But the good thing I say, I don't walk my way for this country. Many people too don't walk their way for this country, and they be okay. So if we feel continue to be work with patience, with humility, with an open mind, trust me, opportunity in this country. Opportunity in this country. So those of us who are interested in policy making, who are interested in government, my own, I say, continue to build your capacity where you are. Continue to do good where you are. Continue to improve on yourself, because opportunity will come. Opportunity for this country. And many times, now your network, kind of people will be saying, they all will be following, will be saying, they think like you. Now it will open opportunity for you. So what they don't say, these politicians, and their children will take over. Now, lie. Their children will be take over. So long as many of us in this country will say, we smart. So if your children go there, So as I say, my laptop, after all pictures in my laptop screen, everyone in front of my laptop like this, and after all picture I just see. Why? Because the next few years, 3 years of now, I don't really target my team, we go play for them. And I want to go make change and impact. So I will keep that vision in front of me every day, every morning. So I say to young people, keep an open mind. Yes, things are bad, we know. Things are tough, we know. You can't look encouraging. But the truth, there are opportunities in the land. Many of us came from background, humble background. But the good thing is, we are on our path, and we are building our profile. And the people is extremely bright. For people that come to mind in Nigeria.
Elder David, thank you very much for all this talk where we say you don't talk. The one went touch me now, and I say, you say picture of Aso Rock there for the screen of your laptop, say, because you don't tell yourself, say, coming soon, I will be here doing things to move Nigeria to the promised land. God bless you. We hope, say, all your dreams and wishes will come true. And we believe, say, God bless Nigeria with young people when we say they sabi well, well. And because of the blessing when God don't give us. And in fact, say, this country, our country, when we say they bless, we go enjoy this country together and we go work to make our country better. Thank you very much.